Good morning. His Excellency Dr. Kikyo Chantaburi, Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Planning and Investment, Lao PDR. His Excellency Mr. Susat Saithamani, Deputy, Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, Lao PDR. His Excellency Mr. Mai Seyabong, Director General of Asia Pacific in Lao PDR. Mr. Thampa Senthakam, Secretary General of Lao National Chamber of Commerce. Mr. Indrani Chowdhury, Deputy Director General, Finer and Member of Finer Delegation from India. Mr. Subhash Bhargavar, Vice President, Indian Chamber of Commerce, Lao PDR. Respected representative from ministers, Ambassador, Republic Embassy of Cambodia, Host, Yuen Thong MPS, Embassy of United States of America, Andro Buntrup Economic Officers, Government Officials, Foreign Delegates, Representative of United Nations, Representative of National Chamber, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for coming to the Indian Lao PDR Business Seminar on trade investment opportunities in Lao PDR, supporting the current vision and policy of Government of Republic of India and Lao PDR. This event will give us the opportunity to exchange on topics about various investment opportunities in Lao PDR, bilateral trade policies, FDI foreign direct investment opportunities, and cultural exchange. All the end of the business forum will have two opportunity to strengthen our ties in person as well as trade and political. In the Indian Chamber of Commerce in Lao PDR, feels very much privileged to jointly organize this seminar with the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, Lao PDR, Ministry of Planning and Investment, Lao PDR, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Lao PDR, and the Lao National Chamber of Commerce, on behalf of Indian business community and Indian Chamber of Commerce in Lao PDR, and Federation of Industry and Commerce on Northeast region in particular. I feel very much humbled and honored for the opportunity to address this business seminar. It is a daunting task to relate the process and milestone made towards developing business relations between our two countries in such a short term. I myself strongly believe that growing and strengthening bilateral trade and investment exchange between India and Lao PDR is to the benefit for all of us. Our major objectives are to promote economic exchange in the areas of trade and investment between Lao PDR and India. Exchange of economics, data and information that will supplement the enhancement of the trade between two countries. Arrange business seminar and important events also for networking purpose and develop and strengthen the mutual friendship and goodwill between the people of India and Lao PDR. The Lao government, which is protective and pro-investment policies, take special efforts towards continuous improvement of investment and business environment. The provision of one-stop service and the enhancement of related laws are one proof of Lao government's sincerity. The consistent development of human resources through vocational school and development of infrastructure, health, education, agriculture and tourism a sum of priority areas for Laos government. The key is the build upon the region's potential matters only if we can channel it in the best way possible. The Lao PDR already has a brand name that which symbolizes Laotian legendary hospitality, beauty and cultural diversity. Lao PDR is home to many important religious monuments and historical sites such as Lumphabang, UNESCO World Heritage Site, or Wat Pho. We should work towards building on this brand. The government policies of the Lao PDR is to improve, empower, and enrich the country and help make its residents and stakeholders in the process. Current policies of the Laotian government concentrate on setting and the entrepreneur friendly economical infrastructure which enforce sustainable economic growth. Northeast of India has a very important strategic location, nestled between Bangladesh, China, Bhutan, and Myanmar. It is ideally positioned for the transborder trade. Moreover, in the neighboring ASEAN region, is one of the most dynamic economic regions of the world today. The Lucas policy of our governments offers a wonderful opportunity to transform the whole economical landscape of this region. I'm proud to be Indian and further a Northeast Indian. Wherever I go in the world, I proudly wear my heritage and legacy and always try to be the best possible ambassador of our beautiful, colorful, and vibrant culture. I have had a pleasure of serving as the president of Indian Chamber of Commerce in Lao PDR and also organizing high profile delegation from Laos and India, several seminars with state government of Assam, India, state government of Nagaland, FICCI, CIA, ASSOCHAM, FINER, and Assam Chamber of Commerce. Once again, I would like to express my honest and highest opportunity to the attendance and participation of all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.